late at night on the open road, speeding like a man on the run. A lifetime spent preparing for the journey. He is closer now, the search is on. Reading from a map in the mind. Yes, there's the ragged hill and there's a boat on the river. And when the rain came down, he heard a wild dog howl. Though a voice says in the night,
don't do it.
Voice says out of sight,
don't do it.
Too many men have failed before. Whatever you do, don't pay the ferryman. Don't even fix it.
Oh, you gotta love 80s rock, man. All kinds of stuff, even that great classic by Christa Burke, Don't Pay the Ferryman, and I'm sure that's one of the reasons why we've been banned in Germany. That's right, Gorilla Blood Radio, banned in Germany, and damn proud of it. What you got to say about that
one? I'm a quarter not proud of it. A quarter of me is not very proud of that.
Are you part German?
Quarter of me, yeah.
He's a quarter German. And
I'm a quarter upset that we're banned in one of my own countries.
I'm telling you, we got banned in Germany. I don't know how we did it, but we should take... How many things get banned in Germany? Well, wait.
I mean, have you seen some of the shit that comes out of Germany and we're banned?
Yeah, I know Eric Cartman's mom.
That's what pisses me off.
Wasn't Eric's...
I think we're pretty fucking tame compared to most of all the German schlock that comes out of there.
Yeah, didn't Eric...
I don't even want to fucking talk about their interest in porn.
Yeah, I mean, Eric Cartman's mom did porn over there, didn't she?
Oh, gosh.
Didn't she, though, Daniel?
Yes.
Yeah, I thought so. I remember that. I remember Eric Cartman's mom did porn.
Wasn't that part of the Bigger, Longer, Uncut?
I think so.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I actually really ever enjoyed from South Park after the first few seasons.
The movie?
Was the one movie that they did, and after that, I really couldn't get back into the show.
Isn't Hasselhoff from Germany, or at least his heritage is?
He's huge in Germany.
Yeah.
Because of his German background. He's not a bad singer, though. Have you actually heard him sing?
No. Other than the clip of him singing at the Berlin Wall, no.
You actually should look up clips from his albums. He's done some really fun songs. He actually did the theme song to the recent Kung Fu short. I forgot what it was called.
Fury and...
Yes, Kung Fury. He did the Lone Survivor song.
Here we go. It's called True Survivor.
Got those guns?
Holy.
I've got your permit right here.
Damn! Holy hell.
Permit denied.
Guys.
This is so 1980s it hurts. And it's perfect for it.
I put the link to the YouTube video in the chat room. You're going to have to check it out, man.
Seriously, the music video is like a great little tribute to the video itself.
Wow. David Hasselhoff looks good as hell, man. Michael Knighton. Oh, bad. That's bad. Wicked.
He was also one of the coaches in Dodgeball.
Yes, he was. You have to admit, he's got a decent voice.
How 80s.
That actually isn't that bad.
It's actually
I'm
really
telling
good.
You. And yes, this is as 1980s as you can fucking get with a song.
I gotta admit though, he's at least on a scale of like holiday kids special at the high school. On a scale from that all the way to like Whitney Houston, he's at least better than Eddie Murphy.
I don't know, man. Party all the time was hot.
Okay, put it this way. He's way better than any person.
Is he Jamie Foxworthy, though?
Nope, he's better than Jeff Foxworthy.
How the hell do you have a video with a car getting flipped by a skateboard, samurais, and a dinosaur in it. That's bad as hell. I love this. This is awesome.
Giant fucking robot going around.
Dinosaur just on the prowl. Got the old 80s style computer. The song's catchy. I like the song. I actually like it. Wow.
I shit you not. When I first heard this song, I've listened to it like 6 times in a row. It's such an entertaining song. And if you listen to Hasselhoff's other songs, you actually realize he's a damn fine singer.
Wow. Not bad at all. I'm going to have to download that.
Maybe they fiddle with his voice a little. Who cares? The guy can carry a tune better than I can.
Yeah, definitely.
I'd rather listen to him than me singing.
Well, we know he can carry a tune better than me.
Listen to him sing than me talk. Can't we just have a show of all David Hasselhoff and we just shut the fuck up?
We could do that 1 week. Yeah, we'll do the That laugh you're hearing, I've neglected to introduce our buddy out there in Arizona, David, the NWO reviewer. How you doing, David?
Hey, I'm doing good, babes.
Are you? Been a while since you've been on Gorilla Blood.
Yeah, it has. How's that?
He was with us for the post-TLC show, which was pretty damn fun, I think.
Yeah, it was.
It was post show
good.
Or TLC?
The post-TLC show.
Oh, okay.
All right, then. Anyway, this
TLC
is Gorilla Blood. Guys, I got to tell you, I work as a security guard, and I got to tell you, I had... Daniel, I told you I was going to talk about this. Please, if you're easily offended, you shouldn't be listening to Gorilla Blood any damn way.
That's
but
true.
I have a story to tell you. Monday night, I work a property out here called Hesperian Falls. Now, this is a ghetto property, and my night goes pretty normal, you know, walking around, documenting, you know, trash here, trash there, dumpsters full, garbage all over, you know, used condoms here, used condoms there. For the life of me, I never thought this would happen. My night's over. It's 1:30 in the morning. I'm wrapping up my paperwork. And I get my paperwork done, and I'm do my final round. I walk around the whole complex, which encompasses about 2 normal city blocks. It's a huge property. It's about the perimeter walk's about 20 minutes. And I have to do this once an hour. So I'm doing my final perimeter, and I come upon the mailroom. And I notice a man and a woman with long braided hair going into the mailroom. Now, nothing unusual in that. However, the door gets closed and the light goes off. So, you know, I'm a man just like anyone else. So I figure, boom, boom, something's going on in there. And I'm thinking maybe it's a hooker picked up a trick and she's going to turn a trick in this mailroom. So I go over to the mailroom and I knock on the door. No answer. And it's locked. But I know there's 2 people in there because I watched them enter. I take out my bright-ass flashlight, which is as bright as the headlights on a semi-rig, and I shine it in the window, and I don't see nothing. And I look over by the door, and I see a couple of half-naked bodies. Well, I'm a security guard, and this is a common area. I've got other, you know, residents. We've got like 300 apartments here, so I have to get them out of there. So I knock on the door. Security! Can you open the door for me, folks? I know you're in there. Can you open the door? The door opens, and much to my surprise and my chagrin, what I thought was a male and a female were 2 guys. They were both half-clothed, and they were fully clothed when they went in.
Oh, God.
Yes. So.
Well, one would hope that they were fully clothed when they went in.
Yeah, they were not fully clothed when I got there. The one was pulling his pants up and buckling himself up and stuff. So I asked for names, and, you know, being embarrassed, they didn't want to give me their names. And they didn't actually live on property. They had hooked up at one of the little casino places out here called Dottie's and decided to have a little fling on their way to home or whatever. And that was the end of my night on Monday. And I'm grateful that it ended that way because I got to laugh my ass off about that situation. I've never had that happen before. And to be honest with you, I'm glad that I couldn't see more than I actually saw when I looked through that window, because I might not be here right now. I might be in a little white room in a little jacket that buckles in back, because I have no problem with alternative lifestyles. However, when you're doing something like that, don't do it in public. Because you never know who's going to walk up. There might have been a woman and her kids walk up there and catch that going on. And I don't want any child to see that going on. If you're out there and you feel like getting jiggy with it in public, if you will, do it in your car. Find a back alley somewhere, you know, someplace where no one's going to catch you or see you. For God's sakes. For God's sakes, folks. You're going to traumatize people. And I'm a frail person anyway. I mean, I'm like a flare. I cry at anything. Anyhow, that was my Monday. Other than that, the week's been good. Got a call today. Got a new property. And for some reason, I'm the go-to guy at my company. When we get new properties, they put me on them. So I'm being moved from where I've been, which has only been about 20 hours a week, to a new property, which is closer to my home and is actually a 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. or 7 p.m. to 3 a.m. shift 5 days a week. So I get my 20 hours back and go back to full time, which I'm very happy about, especially since my birthday's coming up. I'm going to be 47 years old here in about 1 month. I'm a month from being 47, so I'm getting old.
Damn, dude.
Yeah, I'm getting old. But you know what? Age is nothing but a number, to quote. What was that, Tommy Dreamer? Who said that? Age is nothing but a number?
Yeah, but you need hair.
Yeah, I think so.
I have hair. I have a lot of hair.
See, you're lucky that Tommy doesn't.
No, but then again, Tommy's taking a lot of bumps to the skull.
I kind of want to start lining up some of these balding wrestlers and just project movies on the top of their heads.
You know who looks bad balding? Sting looks horrible. And has anyone noticed Taker's hairline is crawling to the back of his head also?
He's really trying to make that dead look come alive.
I'm waiting for he does that flip thing where he flips over the three strands to make it look full.
This isn't, you know, Paul Heyman.
No. Nobody can be Paul Heyman, though.
It's hilarious how many wrestlers, like Luke Harper, got all of his long-ass hair, and then he looks like he's wearing a flesh-colored yarmulke.
Oh, I believe that. Yeah, that was good. Oh, God. So, Scott, that leads into what happened over on my normal property out there. Off of the Decatur and Sahara here in Vegas. Somebody moved and they tossed out a box of DVDs.
Again?
Yeah. And not
Did
just...
Did you already find a box of DVDs before?
Yeah, I found maybe like 15, but this time I found like 50. Dude, I have Saw 1, 2, 3, and 4 now.
I what? Guess that's good.
Yeah, that's awesome. I liked it.
I have Ip Man.
See, now that I want to see.
And I have something I'm sending your way, Scott, because I don't own a Blu-ray. There was a Blu-ray copy of I Am Legend.
Ooh, I'll upgrade mine.
And I will send you the copy. There's no liner notes, but the disc is in mint condition, and I will ship it your way to New York there.
If there's a few other movies you want to throw in that package, I won't argue. I'm just saying.
Well, why don't you guys talk, and I'll go grab my little box, and we'll discuss some of them. And, Scott, you can tell me whether they're... How about we do a quick little segment with the movies, crap or not? I'll be right back.
Okay. Well, I guess it all depends. It's all subjective. I mean, I think a lot of shit's crap, but...
Yeah, how's your DVD December going? Since we...
I kind of hit a bit of a brick wall because I've been tired lately, so I've been sleeping at night-ish. So, I tried to watch a movie called Doctor of Doom last night. It is actually a Mexican movie from the 1960s that features female luchadors.
Nice.
Seriously. And the weird thing was, I was so getting into it. For some reason, this guy wants to transfer one brain to another body. I don't fucking know why. It doesn't really explain too much about it. Although, he transferred the brain of a gorilla into a man's body and type of character in the film. But, there's really no reason for him to do this other than he's a mad fucking scientist, you know?
Now, that movie is only missing one thing so far.
What?
What's her name from The Big Bang Theory? has some hot babe in the film.
Well, let's.
Well, they had their own hot babes. Well, 1960s hot, I guess.
Speaking of hot babes, how about Critters, the original?
God, I want that 4-disc set. But I'm still in the middle of something, Boos. We'll get to your DVDs in a moment.
Oh, okay.
We're working on DVD December. We're talking about a movie I haven't got to yet.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm trying to watch it, but I fell asleep about 20 minutes before the ending of it, so I have to rewatch the last 40 to make sure I know what I'm doing. But it's called Doctor of Doom. You know? Let me see if I could pull that up on the old IMDb. And it's from 1963. A mad scientist terrorizes a city, kidnaping young women with his ape-man Gomar. Then using them as subjects in sadistic brain transplant experiments. Now, every brain he tries to use dies! Because, you know, it's a fucking brain transplant. So he thinks if he uses the brains of a professional wrestling woman, their strong bodies would equal strong minds. So he's trying to kidnap this one woman who's a pro wrestler, a luchadora, but they don't call it that because it's translated as fuck. You know, so they're all pro wrestlers. I want them to be called luchadors. Pro wrestlers! Anyway, you know what? For 1960s film of this caliber, it's actually really fucking entertaining. And I'm disappointed that I didn't get to finish it because it really has something interesting on it. It's part of a 2-disc set, which actually I have a poster of here, so I don't have to look up the actual other movie. It's called Wrestling Women vs. the Aztec Mummy. I've seen that.
That's available.
I've heard of that.
Yeah, that's on. I watched that on YouTube right after I watched the Aztec Mummy.
Well, I don't have to watch it on YouTube because I own it on DVD.
Well, lucky you.
I think so. So, yeah, Doctor Doom has been entertaining as hell so far. I'm disappointed I didn't get to finish it. And I was actually going to do a double feature if I didn't zonk out last night like I did of Wrestling Women versus the Aztec Mummy. For old school black and white films, this shit's pretty entertaining so far.
And it was directed by Tim Burton, of all people. Nice. Nice.
Say what?
Yeah, Tim Burton and Jerry Reeves are the directors. I'm looking at it right now on YouTube.
Yeah. No, director was Rene Cardona.
Well, this is Wrestling Women vs. Doctor of Doom, directed by Jerry Reese and Tim Burton.
Tim Burton wasn't directing films in the 60s.
I don't know. That's in 1963.
Yes, and it was directed by Rene Cardona, who directed also Wrestling Women vs. the Aztec Mummy.
Okay, I see. Well, then YouTube has it wrong.
No shit!
Which is not unusual for things on YouTube.
I mean, okay. I just watched the part of the movie. The credits actually credit this guy. I didn't see Tim Burton up there once.
Okay.
Jesus.
All right.
Anyway, it's definitely a film I think all y'all should eventually watch.
All right.
I get more of them. Ooh, there's another set. Let me see what this one. Oh, it looks like Curse of the Aztec Mummy.
That's the one I've seen on YouTube.
And The Robot versus the Aztec Mummy. God, I must find this and add this to my Amazon wish list.
They are so horrible.
Oh.
They really.
Why wouldn't I still want to own them, though? Have you seen my movie collection?
No, I know that you own some really shitty films, though.
I've taken photos. It's on my Instagram. If you take a look, you'll see them.
All right.
So, I've actually photographed everything that I've watched so far. I have not photographed the stuff that I haven't watched so far because I'm actually embarrassed.
Okay. Yeah, some of the movies I found, speaking of that, man, and one I want to see because I've heard about this one is called Detour.
Haven't heard of it.
One wrong turn and you're fresh meat. Yeah.
There's wrong turn.
That doesn't ring a bell to me.
Wrong Turn 6, Joyride. I mean, that really doesn't you know, narrow it down.
Well, it's a film by the Asylum, so, you know,
Oh, you're fucked.
It's going to be crap.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be garbage, but I can't
wait to see it. Oh, no, that's beyond garbage. Okay. That's, you know, get the razor blade ready. I'm going to kill myself after this film.
And then I have one here that's in mint condition. I think I'm going to send it to our buddy Brian Perez. It's called Thomas and French Engines and Escapes. Escapades.
Is it a Disney movie?
No, it's Thomas the Train.
Still, I think this Disney might own that now if they own everything else. Probably I just had to make sure because I really want those Disney movie rewards.
The widescreen collection of special collector's edition of The Hunt for Red October.
Ooh.
Which is a great-ass freaking movie. One of my favorites, and I know you guys are going to make fun of me for it, but What's Love Got to Do with It with Angela Bassett and Lawrence Fishburne. That's a great movie.
I don't think I've ever seen it.
Critters, the original, in mint condition, was still in the wrapper.
Oh, you bastard.
Oh, and you know what? I am a huge fan of the Critters series altogether.
Yeah, but Critters 2 is the best one, the Critters ball that just leaves a skeleton.
Yeah. Dante's Peak, the collector's edition.
Nice.
Underworld Evolution, widescreen
special. I'm sorry.
You're not an Underworld fan?
I am not an Underworld fan. I watched I, Frankenstein recently, and I was just like, oh, look. To me, it was just Underworld 3.5.
And then I kind of got, like, a little goosebumpy and giddy when I found out that this was in there. A double feature from Paramount, Footloose and Flashdance on one DVD.
Guess what? I bought that not too long ago.
It's a great – dude, I'm a huge – Footloose was, like, you know, I was a kid in the
80s. Footloose is still awesome. The only problem is they re-rated it to PG-13.
Let's see.
This and I was yelling PG. At my TV screen when I saw that. Like, fuck you, Footloose is PG!
Yeah, it's PG.
We didn't have PG-13 in 1982!
And then, Flashdance is the 83 R-rated version.
Well, so there's only one version.
Well, no, the one for TV, they cut out the good stuff.
Well, it's made for TV, of course.
Let's see. A movie called Trucker.
Never heard of it.
Neither have I.
Nope.
It stars Michelle Monaghan, Nathan Fillion, and Benjamin Bratt.
Oh, Nathan Fillion? That's pretty good. I like him. He's good. So,
we'll see
about 2008? It is... Yeah, 2008.
2010 is what it says here.
Well, that's probably when the DVD was released.
Yeah, and then Saw number 2. I'm just going through the list of them here that I have. I've got a pile stacked up here. Elizabeth Town, which is actually a pretty damn good movie, even though it's a drama. I've seen this before. It's an actual...
Nothing wrong with dramas. Dramas and even romances can be good movies.
This has got Kirsten Dunst in it, so it can't be all bad. I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Oh, Lord.
Little Fockers.
Just that reaction from David. Oh, Lord.
An Ice Cube movie called The Players Club. With, looks like... Oh, Bernie Mac's in it. Ice Cube's in it. John Amos is in it. Jamie Foxx is in it. This has got to be a good movie.
Yeah, this could be good.
Yeah, it's an Ice Cube film.
It could be good.
It could be very
especially good. Since Bernie Mac is apparently named Dollar Bill in it.
The original 2-disc set of The Osbournes Season 1.
Huh. Well, if you want to not understand what Ozzy's saying, go ahead and watch that.
I don't think anyone's understood what Ozzy said for decades.
Not even Ozzy, and he says it.
Exactly. A movie featuring Peter Dinklage called Pete Smalls is Dead.
Nice. There's a short joke in that title. Well, he happens to be in the movie.
It's also got Steve Buscemi in it, and I am a huge fan of Steve Buscemi's work.
Which is funny, because Peter Dinklage is almost as tall as Steve Buscemi.
A movie...
Or is it maybe Steve Buscemi is just as short as Peter Dinklage?
Let's see now. Oh, here's a great one here. From 2000, the remake... of one of the greatest films ever made, Shaft.
And no, burn it.
It was Samuel L.
Burn it. There's even a few things Samuel L. Jackson can't save.
The two-disc collection of Goodfellas.
Nice. I would be asking for that if I didn't own that on Blu-ray already. I would actually be begging for that right now. It's one of my favorite films of all time.
Let's see. I have 2 weeks' notice with Sandra Bullock and Hugh Grant. File that under ich. To Honor and Deceive, a Fremantle Media production. You know, that's the company that Eric Bischoff was a part of for a while. They were trying to buy WCW back in the day. To Honor and Deceive with Vanessa Marcel, James Wilder, and Thomas Gibson. Her son has been kidnapped by the most dangerous man she knows. Well, we have Hugh Grant and Drew Barrymore, music and lyrics. Sandra Bullock in a damn good movie, 28 Days with Sandra Bullock.
That's an okay film. I don't think it's a damn good movie. Yeah. It's an okay film.
I have an old Steve Reeves film, The White Warrior. I'm telling you, this is going to be racist as hell.
Hey, real quick. You mentioned 28 Days. Uh-huh. I get really pissed off when I see that movie on my TV guide menu thing, thinking it's 28 Days Later.
Yeah, yep.
Your problem for not reading the whole title.
I get really pissed.
Okay.
I see the very beginning of it. I'm like, ooh, oh, crap, damn it, not that movie again.
Oops, just so you know, I actually own The White Warrior.
Yeah, is it any good?
I don't know. It's on my To Get Rid of Kyle. I never watched it. I got like a dollar DVD my dad bought.
Okay, yeah, it's a Steve Reeves film, so I'll watch it for a laugh.
Watch it one day, because I eventually watched The Black Brigade, and that wasn't that bad.
Now, I don't know much about this. I've heard about it, but it stars Richard Dreyfuss, so I'll probably watch it. My Life in Ruins?
No, I haven't heard that one.
It's got Richard Dreyfuss in it, so I'm gonna have to watch it because I'm a Richard Dreyfuss fan. It's about the only name I know is Richard Dreyfuss. Here's a movie for all of us. Oh my God! It stars Macaulay Culkin as an adult called Sex and Breakfast.
What the?
Never heard of it.
The fuck?
James, Macaulay Culkin, and Heather Alexis Dezenia, along with Ellis Kuno Becker and Renee Eliza Dushka.
Eliza Dushku.
Are two 20-something couples whose lives are intertwined as they experiment with group sex in a way to sort out the rudiments of successful relationship sex, love, and communication. After a series of mishaps fueled by jealousy, confusion, and insecurities, they soon find that true love and lasting relationships at their core are ultimately about more than sex and breakfast. Aww.
That sounds bad.
Yeah, it does. It's rated R, too, so... yeah, it's got to be pretty bad. A documentary called Friday Nights in America. Anyone want to take a guess at what it might be about?
High school football.
Damn straight. I will be watching that because I love football.
Yeah, dude. Go to Texas. Oh, my God. They have stadiums in Texas that will rival, like, colleges out here in California.
Oh, yeah. Have a little ditty here called U571.
That's a really good movie.
A little double disc feature here. Featuring Matt Damon, Gwyneth Paltrow, and Jude Law, called The Talented Mr. Ripley.
You know, I watched that when it first came out, and I had no interest in it whatsoever. I want to give that a try again.
You wouldn't be interested in Bible stories from the Old Testament?
Probably not.
The Best of the Power Rangers, The Ultimate Rangers.
Sweet.
And I'll watch it just because it's good old-fashioned.
This is some seriously random-as-fuck collection of videos.
Yeah, and they threw them out. They threw these out, man. Finding Nemo, the two-disc set with a widescreen in full frame.
Very good. Yeah. Again, look for those Disney Movie Rewards in there.
And A Nightmare 4, The Dream Master. I wish it would have been 3 Dream Warriors because that was the absolute best Nightmare film.
That's some of the best debatable.
A set of documentaries from the History Channel, which I dearly love documentaries. A 3-disc collection called World War II. We have disc number one, The War in Europe, part two, Great Blunders, and disc number three featuring Nuremberg, Tyranny on Trial. So I will watch those and love those because I am a huge fan of documentaries. We're still going here. We're still going. Something when I saw it, this is what made me grab them all. Thelma and Louise. One of the greatest films ever made in my eyes.
I've never actually seen it.
Oh, it's such a great film. Such a great movie, man.
I saw it like 8 years ago, I think.
The ending is just the most perfect ending for a buddy film ever when they go off the cliff in the car. That's just so beautiful. A little ditty rated G called The Long Neck Migration. It's a Land Before Time movie.
I was going to say, that sounded like Land Before Time.
Easily.
The two-disc special feature of Atlas Shrugged from HBO Home Video. Yes?
An Atlas Shrugged thing from HBO Video?
I believe it's HBO. Let me look. Huh. Let me look. It's, oh, 20th Century Fox. My bad.
I was going to say, yeah, because they did one Atlas Shrugged. They did it in three parts. If they're the,
I thought it was only two parts.
Yeah. No, they actually did a part three.
Yeah, this is a two-part.
Yeah, they did part two. They did part one, part two, and then part three just came out within the last year or so. Yeah, I mean, they
were... The fuck have I been with that?
It was funny because the movies... As much as I like Atlas Shrugged and Ayn Rand, the movies were very, very... They were casted the first time, and then when the second movie got approved, they had lost a lot of their cast, so it really changed... All the cast members kind of changed, and it didn't really have the same punch.
And then we have The Lake House with Keanu Reeves and Sandra Bullock. How beautiful is she? Oh, my God.
That's that weird time travel film.
I don't care... Is this someone? Yeah, where he puts the note in the mailbox and she gets it years later. And yeah, I remember that. But if I remember, this is actually not a bad movie at all.
I haven't seen it myself. Not for a lack of wanting, I just haven't seen it.
And then a disc of the 10 big box movies of horror. This disc features Meadow Woods, which I've seen, Howling 4, The Original Nightmare, The Nurse, The Familiar, and Killer Killer. Not Driller Killer, but Killer Killer. So there's five.
If you don't want that, throw that in the pile of I Am Legend.
Send to Scott NDX.
Maybe.
Then there's some. Then there's this little ditty here called Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla.
Boo!
Well, that's not up your alley at all.
Oh, no. And then neither is the Gojira. Those are the ones I have sitting to the side here.
I know you would never send me those.
And then neither is the Gojira Raid, Godzilla Raids Again. Or, hold on, I'm not done with that one. Let's go over here to the great other two movies that I found. The Terror of Mechagodzilla. And Godzilla Tai Megaguirus, which would be called Godzilla 2001. And then, from the After Dark Horror Fest collection, 8 Movies to Die For, Crazy Eights. Yes, I have that.
Yeah, most of those films are pretty horrible.
Well, you know. Here's a horror movie that isn't horrible, Scott. The original, not the remake, but the 1970 or 80 version of The Omen.
I've never seen any of The Omens.
Oh, I love The Omen.
Wow.
A little Matt Damon film called Stuck on You.
Ugh.
Then there's this movie called The Book of Esther. Which is biblical.
No comprende.
It's all biblical. It's biblical, man. I know you don't understand. Deal with Burt Reynolds. Never heard of it, but Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds.
The Constant Gardener.
That's supposed to be good.
It's a focus feature. It features Ralph Fiennes and Rachel Weisz.
Ralph Fiennes.
Fiennes, okay. Yeah, I'll watch that one since Scott recommended it.
If you don't like it, I will easily take it off your hands because I want to see that so bad.
And then I have this little cheap-ass thing here called Virtual Combat. Virtual Combat, yeah.
Is that an actual movie?
Yeah. It's a... Well, the broad in it's dressed in like an 80s skin-tight spandex.
Video, 1995.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's got Don the Dragon Wilson in it!
Yeah.
Oh, dear God, I love schlock like this.
It's, yeah, called Virtual Combat.
I bet you I watched this at like 3 a.m. on Showtime at one point.
A little holiday thing from the USA Network called Prancer Returns.
That sounds like a violent film.
Could be. It's a Christmas movie. And finally, coming down to the Ip Man with Donnie Yen, which, no, I've seen this movie a couple of times, and it is just off the hook good. It is actually the story of the guy who trained Bruce Lee, and it is freaking awesome. Little thing that we can all identify with, a George Lopez stand-up call. Why are you crying?
Why
are you crying? Then we have this thing called Trans-Siberian with Woody Harrelson, so it's got to be an okay movie. It's also got Ben Kingsley in it, so that means it just went up a notch there. Eduardo Noriega, Kate Mara, Emily Mortimer, and Thomas Kirchman. You Can't Escape Your Lies is the tag. A Trans-Siberian train journey from Beijing to Moscow turns into a thrilling chase of deception, drug trafficking, and murder. Wow. When Americans Roy, played by Woody Harrelson, and Jesse, Emily Mortimer, and a pair of fellow travelers, Carlos and Abby, are targeted by an ex-KGB detective, Grinko, played by Ben Kingsley. This has got to be a good movie, man.
No, Ben Kingsley does a lot of shit just for money.
Yes,
that is true.
Robot Overlords.
Oh.
Dude, that
was...
Did you wind up watching that after I watched that for Schwartz in November, Scott?
No, I can't. I'm not going to find that shit.
Oh, my God, dude. It was bad. It was just... It was one of those movies where you watch it, and it's not really for Ben Kingsley. He's just kind of there as a villain, kind of, I guess.
And
I'm getting a paycheck.
Yay, paycheck.
Cool. I'm getting a paycheck, too. Anyway, that was my stash of movies that I found. I threw out a whole bunch because they were, like, cheap-ass bootleg. And I threw them
out. Yeah, I don't keep bootlegs either. Unless it's a bootleg I want to see. Then I get rid of it.
I'm pretty happy. I have to go out and buy a DVD player now. So that I can hook it to my TV so I can start participating in things like DVD December, which we could probably, you know, we'll talk about that here, see how Scott's doing with that. And then
he was a little bit when you went to go get the DVDs.
And then, of course, you guys know that tonight, very special Catchphrase Jeopardy edition of Smart Mark Jeopardy here tonight on Gorilla Blood.
Playing what now?
Oh, yeah, we're playing Catchphrase Jeopardy.
I'm glad someone informed me.
You received a text message just like everyone else.
No, I didn't.
Oh, yes, you did. I sent it to you.
When? Today?
No, like 2 days ago.
I didn't get no text message from you 2 days ago.
Hey, look, where's that text message from 2 days ago?
Oh, look, Harry sent me a text message 2 days ago.
It's not going to take that much
from you.
It's not going to take that much brain power.
Yes, it was.
I don't have time to think about shit.
Two
right
days
now.
Ago, this Wednesday on Gorilla Blood, Catchphrase Madness. We write our own very special Gorilla Blood Christmas Hanukkah song and NXT London Plus, whatever the fuck else, and DVD Summer continues.
Do we really have to write our own Christmas or Hanukkah song?
Well, no, we've already, you know, we're waiting for DVD December with Scott. We needed to continue here. So we're waiting to find out what's going on with DVD December here. This is
Does anyone know where I left off last time?
Where you left off last time is where you left off last time.
I don't know. I think you were like only maybe 4 or 5 in.
Ah, fuck it. I'll just start over.
There you go.
I mean, this year, DVD December also coincided with the 13 days of Creepmas, which is something Horrors Online is very proud to be a consistent participant in.
Now, I got to ask you a question real quick. Does that involve, like, Nick Anthony?
Because no.
That's about the creepiest thing I can think of.
No.
Okay. Okay, go ahead.
Now, for those of you that don't know, the 13 Days of Creepmas is trying to counter the 12 Days of Christmas and the fact that Christmas has been starting in fucking July lately. So we kind of bringing the horror back into the holidays.
You mean like
so
Krampus?
I use this as a way to get past several of my horror movies on my pile of movies to watch list, which just grows and grows because of all the shit that I keep buying. And try and make some room for more shit that I'm just going to keep... Oh, fuck, I hate my pile now. This is so bad. Anyway, I don't know what I'm doing anymore. God help me. Anyway, DV December coincides with the 13 Days of Creepmas. And I decided to use this to watch some movies. First movie I watched was Carnivore, a movie that was started in 1986 and finished in 2000 because it took 14 fucking years to raise the budget to get it done. It looks like someone took a really cheap model of Pumpkinhead and covered it in some fur.
Oh.
It was absolutely atrocious. One of the worst fucking movies I've ever seen. A waste of $2, a waste of an hour and a half, and I can't wait to show this to people I fucking hate. Next, I decided to watch some classics like The Premature Burial, which should have starred Vincent Price, but Roger Corman was like, fuck you guys, I'm going somewhere else, and tried to start the movie somewhere else, and then, you know, MGM just said, fuck you, we're buying this out from under you, and you still have to make it, and he just went, ah, crap. So, it was a really good movie, based off of course, Edgar Allan Poe, followed by The Mask of the Red Death, which did star Vincent Price.
The classic
version?
As part
of his, like, five movie... Edgar Allan Poe deal that he had with MGM at the time.
And they were all great movies, by the way.
Oh, they really were.
Then again, they starred Vincent Price. What more can you say? The master of horror.
I don't have a huge Vincent Price collection, but I do have a good chunk of films of his that I just happened to get at the Salvation Army one day. They just, for some reason, someone donated a shitload of those MGM Midnight Movie 2-packs.
Do you have the Twice Told Tales?
No, I do not. But I have The Pit and the Pendulum.
Oh.
I have, of course, Mask of the Red Death and The Premature Burial 2-pack.
Both are good movies.
Yes. I can't tell you offhand the ones that I do have. All I know is that in every fucking film, he's hitting a woman.
That's back when a man was a man, Scott. They weren't afraid to keep their woman in line. Women did not. Talk
every
back
Vincent
to their
Price
man.
Film I've ever seen has him hitting a woman.
No.
The Last Man on Earth, he hits a woman.
Uh-huh. Well, she's a vampire.
House on Haunted Hill, he hits a woman.
Well, she's evil.
Shock! I don't even think he probably even... Have you heard of the movie Shock? 1940? Uh-huh. He hits a fucking woman!
That's back when men were men and they didn't let their women get out
and
of line.
The only film I've ever seen hit a woman in is Edward Scissorhands. Because he's too busy building a kid with scissorhands. What the fuck? I can't make fingers for you, so here's knives.
Yeah, but he knew how to trim hedges real well.
It doesn't matter!
Hey. Edward Scissorhands.
That's one step away from just having chainsaw hands and falling down, cutting off his own fucking leg like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre,
That's the illegitimate stepchild, illegitimate love child of one Fred Krueger.
They tried that movie.
Possibly.
It was
cool. I seen that too. That schlock they made that was like supposed to be Freddy Krueger's
mom. I like
mom.
That fucking movie. I just wish I had the VHS version that was unrated and had like seven more minutes of gore in it.
Speaking of knockoff Freddy Krueger, anybody get a little weirdly turned on by Alexa Bliss last week on NXT?
There's nothing weird about it. I'm always turned on by Alexa Bliss.
No, but the way she was all, like, trying to look all Freddy Krueger-ish.
Boy-yo-yo-yoing.
She'd be wearing a burlap sack and I'll still find her hot.
Okay.
Hey, just so you know that the movie Creed is up at the bootleg movie site.
Uh-oh.
Ah, I wanted to see that in theaters.
Please don't sue us.
Well, you know, the big movie that's coming out here real quick, like... Real quick.
Don't mention it. Don't fucking mention it because I don't have tickets for it. Don't even talk about it.
Don't say episode.
Don't! I'm not joking, dude. I will turn off this show right now.
Well, we've already turned off Alexa Bliss.
You don't know. Maybe she likes how we talk about her.
Hey, Alexa. You're pretty.
You're just making it creepy.
You're really pretty, Alexa.
Yeah.
That's just creepy. And we go.
Beyond creepy. You know, that's that.
I kind of want to.
Can't we get a restraining order? That was restraining order. Creepy.
Oh, God. The schlocky remake of Point Break is up. And,
Watch it. It's fucking great.
I want to see Brooklyn. Have you seen it?
No.
Okay.
Never even seen the original. Anyway, back to DVD December.
There we go.
After this, I watched The Thompsons, which I think is a sequel to a film called The Johnsons or something like that. It's about vampires. It was okay.
Okay.
I mean, I don't have the original. My friend pretty much gave me this because he got the Blu-ray and it came with the DVD. And he's like, you really don't need to see the original for this to make sense. And he's right. You really don't need to see the original for this to make sense. It would help, though, a little. Now, those were all DVDs. This is the first Blu-ray I watched. Harry and the Hendersons.
Yay!
Rick Baker's personal favorite makeup. You know, the guy who played Harry and Harry and the Hendersons was also the Predator?
Was he?
Yeah, because Jean-Claude Van Damme, I heard the story about Jean-Claude Van Damme was originally the Predator.
But he's also like a foot shorter than Arnold Schwarzenegger, and that dude ain't that tall to begin
with. Well, the funniest part about that was he was actually supposed to be doing, I think it was Bloodsport at the time. And, like, his agent actually kind of told him to botch it on purpose so they'd fire him so he can go do the other movie.
Well, it's a good thing he did. Because
and there's actually footage of him in the suit not being able to do damn near anything and, like, falling on his face a lot.
Good. I gotta check out the bonus features on my DVD now, just in case. Anyway, Harry and the Hendersons, I took a chance on this because I loved this movie growing up as a kid. And I figured for $5 Blu-ray, it's mine. But then I sat there going, shit, is this going to live up to my expectations? You ever watch a movie 20 years later and go, what the fuck was wrong with me? Why did I like that? Happens a lot, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, thankfully, it lived up to my memory of it. It was damn entertaining still. And friggin' Harry just looked awesome.
Thank you.
Still just an awesome design of a character, man.
Thank you. Thank you.
I didn't say boobs.
Boobs are awesome.
Boobs are awesome. Not your boobs.
No,
I support the boobs.
Now, you know, I'm not a fan of Harry and the Hendersons because, of course, with my name and the era it came out in, there was no Prince Harry, so it wasn't like everyone was naming their kid Harry. Like they, you know, Harry Potter and all that stuff. I was pretty much of me and one other kid in Akron, Ohio that I met were named Harry, and that was the extent of it, two of us back when I grew up. So I've heard all kinds of, you know, Harry and Henderson's is just something I've heard. So I'm not a huge fan of it.
That's why I hate Beam Me Up Scotty.
Yeah, there you go.
That's why I hate the name Scotty. I really do.
I understand that, and we know that because...
I was going to say, he never actually said that on television at all, and yet people claim that they've heard it.
Yeah.
I know. And they always say that to me.
That's so
funny. And I want to punch him.
So, yeah. Yeah, I would. I don't blame you. I don't blame you at all.
Really hate that shit. Anyway, next movie, DVD called Death Spa.
Death Spa? Is that next to the hostel?
No.
I mean, it sounds like it.
Huh.
It's a movie... I don't even know how to describe this shit. It's weird as fuck.
Yeah, well, you just did. Shit.
A spa pretty much just goes nuts and starts killing people because it's possessed by the owner's ex-wife who killed herself.
The spa
what? Wait,
kills
what?
People?
Wait, what?
The spa kills people?
Yeah, the spa is killing people.
Wow.
Apparently, they didn't buy the one from Hot Tub Time Machine.
It's not that. No, it's an actual spa. Like a whole place, man. Like the showers and the shit and the stuff like that. All that type of stuff. It's a full-fledged spa. It's not a pool. A pool with bubbles.
So here's a spa where there's definitely not a happy ending.
Aw.
Wah, wah, wah.
So, yeah, it's a pretty gory film. It's got some really cool effects in it. So it was definitely worth watching. I'm kind of glad I own a copy of it now, even though it's the DVD from my friend's Blu-ray set. Watch Disney's Tarzan, because fuck yeah, Tarzan. Then I decided to run through a few Nightmare on Elm Streets because I have the Blu-ray set.
Mm-hmm.
And I needed to finally watch this shit, so I watched the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth already as part of my DVD December and 13 Days of Creepmas.
Mm-hmm.
I finally watched the original Fright Night, which is actually a lot of fun.
And a good movie.
Mm-hmm. And I watched the original Christmas Evil. And behold the silence.
Chirp, chirp.
Now, last year was on DVD December, I watched Ghostbusters and Ghostbusters 2 on Blu-ray.
Ghostbusters, who are you going to call? Ghostbusters was one hell of a movie. I mean, where else do you get to zap the Stay Puft Marshmallow guy? That's just such a great film.
Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
Man, guy, whatever. It's my childhood.
Your childhood? No, it's not your childhood. It's your middle ages.
I was my teenage years.
Your middle ages.
I was a teenager when Ghostbusters came out.
So you're not a child.
Well, no, but it was my childhood, and people keep trying to steal it. The 80s were great. Thank you, America. Gotta love the decade of Ronald Reagan.
And we're back to David Hasselhoff.
Yes. Michael. I'm
anyone
a talking
else doing
car
this?
With a guy driving underneath
doing
the sun.
Am I the only one doing DVD December?
I'm going to go buy it. I get paid Monday. I'm going to go buy me a DVD player so I can start watching mine so I can participate.
You keep getting shit as cheap as you do at that pawn shop. You should be able to get a Blu-ray player.
I really think they got them down there for like $20.
Yeah, if you do, you can watch DVDs on them, plus get Blu-rays.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Then I'll want to go get all the Godzilla on Blu-rays.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Because if I'm gonna start a Blu-ray collection, I'm starting with Gojira. It's got to be the original, and then the next movie I buy has got to be the original King Kong. My two all-time favorite movies.
If you're going to buy a Godzilla film, you can't buy Gojira by itself. It comes with the Americanized version also, so you might as well get the Criterion Collection version on Blu-ray.
And that's about $100.
Why is it $100?
Oh, it's not?
I spent $25 for it.
Oh, okay. Well, if it's on Amazon, I'll buy it.
Or wait till July when you get all Criterion's half price at Barnes & Noble.
Oh, okay, okay. I don't know where I got it for $25. I don't know if they got Barnes & Noble out here, though. Vegas is
weird.
That's
why you go to BarnesandNoble.com.
Okay. Okay. Well, on that note, it's top of the hour. DVD December's over. Let's get into a little thing we call Smart Jeopardy. However, this time, there's a little twist. It's Catchphrase Jeopardy here on Gorilla Blood Radio.
I'm ready for this shit. Fuck you.
Fuck you. You're ready. You're always ready for Jeopardy. It's easy as pie.
Nah, you know you never get pulled on it because you can't do that shit.
Oh, gosh. Here we go.
Well, it's going to be simple.
I just want to say this. I'm looking at the Godzilla on Amazon.com. You can buy it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like the digital version.
Mm-hmm.
You can buy it for fucking $20.
Oh, that's not all digital, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just looking at it like, what? Or if you have the Prime version, you can actually watch Gojira English subtitled for free.
Huh?
Yeah.
And I'm a Prime member, so I get that for free then. Oh, cool. I did not know that. I will have to look. Anyway, we're here doing some Smart Mark Jeopardy, a very special edition called Catchphrase Jeopardy. Now, guys, it's real simple. everything's going to involve a catchphrase. Here's our categories for the night. Finish the phrase. Name that wrestler. In the style of, which you have to say the phrase in the style of that particular professional wrestler. Hogan or not? Are these things Hulk Hogan said or not? And finally, our last category before Final Jeopardy will be Vince, Shane, or Stephanie. Which McMahon said what? All right, let's get it going. Let's start the show off with the man who really doesn't want to be here right now. David, how you doing, David?
Hey, I'm doing good.
We'll let you have the first pick tonight. Finish the phrase, name that wrestler in the style of Hogan or not, or Vince, Shane, or Stephanie.
Vince, Shane, or Stephanie for 100.
Make sure you say your name to buzz in.
Right.
Right, I know.
You're fired!
Daniel. Vince.
For 100? All right, let me make sure.
That's basically everybody but Vince.
Right. So let me write a DN for Daniel there so I can keep track of these. Go ahead, Daniel. You're next up.
Same category, 200.
Which way did he go?
David? Shane.
Correct.
Sorry, that sounded like...
Go ahead, David.
Same category, 300.
I'm going to make you my bitch.
Daniel? Stephanie.
All right, Daniel.
Same category.
You son of a bitch.
That's plausibly all of them.
That would have been, what is Vince? Who is Vince? So,
same category. Finish.
What is Vince? Good question.
What is Vince? And for 500 to finish out the category, Vince, Shane, or Stephanie. Wah!
David.
Go ahead, David.
Stephanie.
Correct, David.
What the hell was that?
Back when she was first, when she was the Divas Champion, she always wah'd.
Oh God! Like I was having flashbacks of Nancy Kerrigan and Tonya Harding.
All right. So our remaining categories are finish
I
the
just
phrase.
I just thought of a baby crying.
Stephanie, finish the phrase. Name that wrestler in the style of or Hogan or not. David, you hit your selection.
Hogan or not for 100.
Hogan or not for 100. What you gonna do,
Scott?
Go ahead, Scott.
Hogan.
Nice. Go ahead, Scott. Your pick.
Continue.
Excuse me.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Not Hogan.
Who was it?
It was. Do I get extra points?
It's for 200 points. No, I just wrote that.
Well, I already got it right.
Well, yeah.
Extra points.
All right, you'll get 50 bonus. Well, it's worth 200, so you get 50 bonus.
Vicky Guerrero.
Thank you.
There you go.
Continue.
Know your role and shut your mouth.
Scott.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Scott.
Oh, really? Okay. Not Hogan, The Rock.
Okay.
What the?
Scott came in first. I heard Scott call in and then David.
Oh.
I actually heard Scott.
And Daniel just kind of went, Daniel.
Yeah, you got to speak up, guys, because I'm old. You know, going to be 47 here. Go ahead, Scott.
Continue.
Deal with it.
Daniel?
David.
Go ahead, Daniel.
Not Hogan. That would be Bautista.
Nice job, Daniel. I didn't think anyone was going to get that.
I forgot. I knew that was not Hogan, but I was trying to remember who it was.
Yeah.
I forgot. I could just cock it and say not Hogan.
All right. Go right ahead.
Finish it.
Woo, woo, woo. You know it.
Daniel. Scott!
David.
Daniel got that one.
Daniel.
At Zack Ryder, not Hogan.
All right, Daniel, plus the bonus of 50 for
no
one who
figured at least you put one more fucking Hogan in there or something.
He wanted to mess with it.
Oh, hell. All right.
The category, not Hogan.
Remaining categories, finish the phrase, name that wrestler, and in the style of.
In the style of for 100.
All right. In this category, I'm going to give you the catchphrase, and you have to repeat it in the style of, and everyone judges whether you get the points or not. Okay?
Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah.
All three of us get the answer on this one?
Anybody can chime in, yeah, but you got to do it in the style, and then the guys who didn't get in actually get to judge whether you did it right or not, or good enough to win the points. Okay, in the style of for 100. Oh, yeah, dig it.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Oh, yeah, dig it.
Guys, did he get it?
Yes.
All right. Yeah, I think he nailed Macho. I think he nailed.
This is like the easiest category for points ever.
We're going to see now. Go ahead, Scott.
We're going to continue this point, brother.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Daniel.
Scott.
Go ahead, Daniel.
Can you dig it, sucker?
All right. We'll give that to Daniel. Go ahead.
Yes.
Daniel? All
right, go ahead. Same one.
Oh, what a rush.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Damn. No, I have to do this one. What a rush.
What do you guys say? Give it to him?
Yeah, hell yeah.
All right. All right.
Yeah. I've practicing that one a long time.
All right. Continuing the category then?
Of course.
You'll never ever be the same again.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
You'll never ever be the same again.
I like
he gets
that.
The points yes. Said again properly.
Again, yep. I love it. I love it. And
of course, finish this one out. Please.
All right, all right. I see you like this category here, guys.
Yes,
I
do.
Mr. Kennedy. Kennedy.
Daniel.
Go ahead, Daniel.
Fuck you for putting that one in there.
I knew it. I knew it. Oh, go ahead, Daniel.
I'm raising to the sky for my microphone.
All right, all right, all right.
Mr. Kennedy.
Yeah.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Kennedy.
Okay, let me mark that down as being a hit category. We like that one. We like that one. That's fun.
He gets the points, unfortunately, because he did do it right.
Yeah, he does.
But fuck Ken Anderson.
Even the wait for it.
Yeah.
I had to do the wait for it part. Technically, that's almost Anderson. That's more Anderson shtick, but no.
All right. We have two categories left. Finish the phrase and name that wrestler.
Name that wrestler, 100.
If you're not cheating, you're not trying.
David,
go ahead.
Israel.
Thank you, David. Go ahead, David.
Man, not bad.
Same for 200.
I'm the man of the hour, the man with the power, too sweet to be sour.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Superstar Billy Graham.
Nailed it.
Nice.
I love that too sweet to be sour line, man.
All right. Continue?
Of course.
Okay. We are evil, indeed.
Scott!
Go ahead, Scott.
Damn it!
Kaientai!
There you go!
Damn it! I was just talking to Boobs about Kaientai this morning.
Okay, I guess we're going to continue. Now this one, if you do it in the right style, you'll get 50 bonus points if you get the answer. Oh, you didn't know? Your ass better call. Go ahead, David.
The Road Dog.
That's it. Minus 400 for David.
Daniel,
go ahead.
I'm going to guess you're going to talk about the whole thing, but the New Age Outlaws.
Exactly. Like I
technically,
said,
David's half right.
Well, yeah, but technically don't count when it was the New Age Outlaws catchphrase.
Oh, wait, how are we doing this one? Are we doing the whole catchphrase or just part of it?
Somebody.
It's just, that's their catchphrase, and it was the New Age Outlaws catchphrase. Oh, you didn't know? Yo ass better call somebody. Or however.
Because I always preferred their other catchphrase.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages,
D-Generation X, proudly brings to you, it's WWF Tag Team Champions!
Champions of the world!
The Young Dog Jesse James! The Badass Billy Gunn! The New Age Outlaws!
I'm going to give both David and Scott a bonus of 50 points for that.
And if you ain't down with that,
We got two words for you.
Suck it!
All righty. And finishing out the category, name that wrestler. For 500 points, everybody has a price.
Daniel.
Go ahead, Daniel.
For the $1 million man.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's the $1 million man, Ted DiBiase.
There you go. That's what we're looking for. It's called Name That Wrestler. And our final category, Daniel, finish the phrase. Basically, I'm going to start it. You're going to give me the ending to it.
I'm not going to be able to do this one.
Oh, you're going to love this one. It's easy. Daniel, for
100? Yeah, it's 100.
Welcome to...
Daniel?
Go ahead, Daniel.
First thing I think of is, welcome to the doghouse. Oh, boo. It's actually a catchphrase, though.
Anybody else?
No.
All right. I would have accepted Welcome to Raw is Jericho or Monday Night Jericho.
Oh, that's what you're going for? Okay.
Yeah, that's the most welcome to.
I was thinking that. Funny enough, I was just thinking about that.
Yeah, that would have been Jericho. Okay, for 200. For the benefit of those.
Daniel.
Scott.
David.
Daniel.
For the benefit of those with flash photography.
There you go. Nice job. Scott, you better jump in on this one real quick. For 300 points, J-E-double-F-J-A.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Double-R-E-double-T.
Finish it.
There's more than that?
I'm waiting for it. I'm waiting for two little things at the end.
there you go.
Now say the whole thing right for me.
J-E-double-F-J-A-double-R-E-double-T.
There you go.
Scott. I was like waiting for the lap.
I was going to use that one on in the style of, but I got it up there. Okay, for 400 points. Oh, my brother.
Scott.
Go ahead, Scott.
Testify.
There you go, Brother Devon. And finally, clearing out the category for 500 points. Limousine riding. Jet flying.
Daniel.
Go ahead, Daniel.
Kiss stealing, wheeling, dealing.
Son of a gun.
Yeah, son of a gun. I didn't know if you wanted me to go all the way that way.
Well, yeah, it's the whole catchphrase.
Okay, well, he changes it up all the time.
So you got that. Now let me add up the scores here while you guys talk about, you know, Final Jeopardy here.
Okay, I'll which is category scores. Is what?
Right. It's going to be called Who Said It?
Okay.
Who said it? Okay.
You do notice we basically had two categories the whole time, even though we had five?
Yeah, but the one... yeah.
Now six is basically the same thing. Which name the wrestler?
Daniel, Scott...
I'm glad there's so much variety this show.
And David, yes.
Oh, dude. Okay, I'm a little pissed off at this. Somebody just posted an image up. Somebody posted, I guess, a link to... a Twitter or an article or podcast or whatever, something that Vince Russo was pissed off about Kevin Owens being fat and talking shit about Kevin Owens.
Yep.
And
well, what a shock.
Yeah, well, Kevin Owens comes back on Twitter and says, I'm very proud of the fact that I'm not Vince Russo's cup of tea. Quite frankly, I'd be worried if I was.
And so would I.
Well, somebody went and posted this, and the image is being sent on the Skype, and for David who can't see it, it's a picture of Shamu performing, and it says, Fight Owens, fight.
I'm sorry, that's hilarious.
I'm like, damn it, that's so messed up, but it's so funny.
That's hilarious.
My brain ain't getting hurt.
Thank you, Internet. Thank you. And let's be honest. Kevin Owens is still the best thing on television right now. At least one of them.
Oh, hey.
Amen.
Let me see here.
And Vince Russo's not on television. That says a lot.
Okay. Let me see. Why can't I copy this damn picture?
All right, so, boobs, who's got what?
I'm working on that right now, you guys.
How fucking hard is it to, like, add two and two?
It's not, but there's a lot of twos to add. Remember, not all these are worth the same amount of points. I'm right now getting through In the Style okay. of.
I just posted a thing in the chat from New Japan's Twitter. That is a very, very cool fucking picture. It's of Stan the Lariat Hansen, Terry Funk, and Jushin Thunder Liger.
No, say it right.
Jushin Thunder Liger.
There you go.
I thought that was pretty sweet.
Man, I can't believe I've seen him live twice.
You are a lucky bastard. One of these days, dude, I swear to God, one of these days I am going to get to Japan to go see a Wrestle Kingdom show.
Oh, it ain't going to be Wrestle Kingdom 10.
Yeah, no, because that's in, like, less than a month. It's on Monday, January 4th this year. Monday. It's January 4th every year, but it falls on a different day of the week all the time, which is kind of crazy for a wrestling event.
No, they keep it on the day, and the day is important.
Yeah. Yeah, the January 4th show at the Tokyo Dome, Wrestle Kingdom. It was renamed Wrestle Kingdom in 2007.
Yay.
Okay.
Man, that is a powerhouse group right there.
Yeah, that's a
good Of course, Terry Funk's still rocking the fanny pack.
Yeah.
If you go to horrorsonline.proboards.com, I posted some videos of Mitsuharu Misawa and Kenta Kobashi wrestling each other, but also like 10 hours of Kenta Kobashi matches.
Nice.
And one of them, he's wrestling Stan Hansen when he's still just like a young boy. And him and Hansen are just going at it, man. It's a really good match. Hansen clobbers the fuck out of him to win the match at the end.
All right.
It's a great match leading up to
And
it.
Speaking of New Japan, since we brought it up, Mauro Ranallo is going to be joining SmackDown, which is awesome, the announcer from New Japan on Axis. So that's pretty freaking awesome. So.
I got to give him credit, man, that Shamu is wearing the same colored outfit as Kevin Owens. All right.
Professionalism, boobs.
So going in, huh?
Well, professionalism, even Shamu is.
I'm telling you, yeah, he's dressed properly. He's got the right colors and everything going on. So, at the end of our normal Jeopardy, going into Final Jeopardy, Daniel, 3,700 points.
Holy shit.
Scott, 2,750. David, 450.
You know what it was? I didn't even try the first two rounds. If I actually put some effort into it, I might have more points.
Probably.
All right, so our Final Jeopardy question is, who said it? You know how it works. You send me a private text to me, and
David will be the first one to announce on air because he's the only one on the phone.
Yeah.
So yeah. And
Scott, I will have to message Boobs directly.
Right. So
I'll just be using my Skype because I'm lazy.
The catchphrase is, "Be fair to Flair." Do 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 do.
I don't know this for shit. Did anyone tell how much we're spending here?
You're going to put that in there. You put your wager and the answer. To be fair to Flair. Who said it?
Okay, Google. No, I'm joking.
The funniest part was we used to do that to Brian all the time. I love doing that to Brian when he was on the show.
Alrighty, I'm waiting.
Okay,
on
Google.
Answer.
Oh crap, my phone just.
I'm waiting on Scott's answer here.
Because I don't know.
Well, you still got to wager and send me the text.
Yeah, I sent you something.
Oh, okay.
I know it's wrong, but.
And.
So David gets to say
David,
his,
you get to say yours on air and your wager.
What's your wager?
$450.
Okay.
Answer.
I think this is somewhat of a trick question. I'm going to say Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig. Oh, damn it.
And next, coming in second with 2750, he wagered all of it, and he said Dusty Rhodes, which is the incorrect answer. The man with the plan. The man with 4,477 points. And the only man with the correct answer, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Daniel Correa, congratulations. You are the Smart Mark Jeopardy winner this time with 4,477 points to Scott's zero and Daniel's zero.
You mean David zero.
David zero, yeah.
Woo-hoo!
Yeah. Hina, be
Scott
to
zero also. We all suck, yes.
You guys don't remember the great 90s promos he did? Be
That's
fair to Flair.
Fair to Flair.
Be fair to Flair. Fair to Flair. Be fair to Flair.
I just remember this is not fair to Flair. But then again, I'm freaking 23. I wouldn't.
Dude, they had a whole line of t-shirts that said Be Flair to Fair to Flair that you could buy.
Was it WCW?
WWF.
I don't remember that at all.
It's when he went there with the big gold belt.
When they used to digitize the belt.
That was actually fun.
Oh, dude, okay.
That in the style of was a great round. You guys, that really was a fun round.
Dude, okay, I just found something that made me literally, you heard me say, dude, I just put a link in the thing. I don't know why in the hell they didn't make this sooner. Somebody, as a merch product for New Japan, made a Shinsuke Nakamura teddy bear. It's fucking awesome.
It's Shinsuke.
Dude, that is so fucking cool.
It kind of looks like Michael Jackson in drag.
Does Shinsuke Nakamura looks like Michael Jackson in drag?
Oh, okay.
That's funny. I actually had a kid on one of my badminton teams who he had the same style of haircut and stuff, like all kind of short on the sides and pulled back. And I told my kid, hey, for 2 seconds, can you pose like this? And he goes, why? I go, just do it. And then I show him the picture. He goes, oh, fuck. He had no idea who Shinsuke Nakamura was. He doesn't watch wrestling. But I showed him that picture, and he just went, oh, my God, that's hilarious.
See if I can find this.
Well, let's be honest. A lot of people are not going to know who Shinsuke Nakamura is.
Yeah, no, I know. But it was just funny. Because the kid looked almost dead. Same haircut. He was Filipino, but he's not Japanese. But still. Still pretty.
Damn it, trying to eat the snowman.
Snowman?
Sorry, I'm playing a shark evolution thing. I don't know, I got into this shit now.
Okay.
Apparently now my shark is starving in the bonus round and I'm trying to eat a snowman.
Oh, since we're talking about random stuff on this show because we really don't care what the hell we're talking about, happy birthday goes out to Brian the Claw Perez. And
you can't wish him a happy birthday until he gets back on the show.
Oh, well, can we also wish a happy birthday to our other buddy who happens to have a birthday on the same exact day as Brian? Sean, don't call me Lathrop. Lathrop?
Lathrop,
yeah,
exactly.
We can say happy birthday to him.
Okay, because
not Brian!
Okay. Sorry, Brian, I tried. Happy birthday, Sean.
My buddy Valdo and I actually share the same birthday, too.
Your birthday's coming up here soon, too, right?
No.
When's your birthday?
July.
Okay, why was I thinking it was sooner? Oh, no, maybe I know Boobs is right around the corner. The fun part about having a Christmas birthday, or a friend with a Christmas birthday, rather, is fucking with them and wrapping their birthday presents in Christmas wrap.
There it is.
How come can we get that Shinsuke Nakamura bear at, like, Build-A-Bear Workshop?
You can probably make one. Here we go.
I'd probably buy that then. I'd be like, yeah, I just want the Shinsuke bear, and they just look at me like, what?
Yeah, I would, honestly, I would totally buy that just to have, just for the sake of it. That's pretty fucking cool, I gotta say.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even Nick Anthony. Krampus was there. He was pissed off as hell. Had a great big baseball bat. I want to so bad.
Don't say so bad, but it's a decent film. I enjoy it.
I want to see Krampus. I really do. I love Krampus. You guys know about Krampus, right?
Yeah. My sister went and saw it. I don't know if she cared for it.
It's got a weird animated portion halfway through the film that's just like out of nowhere. That was kind of jarring. It's just like, what? I was like, next time can we just make the whole movie in this? Because that was pretty good. All right, so what are we going to talk about now? Or should we go to commercial break?
Horrorsonline.proboards.com.
Which you won't find this up there.
snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. There must have been some...
Hey, it could be worth... You know what? Just because you did that...
Just because he did what?
I said, please stop.
Oh, God, what are you going to torture us with now? I don't like when he laughs like that. That's usually a bad thing. And he's still laughing!
I'm just waiting for the coffin joke.
There's a song, and it's called The 12 Days of Christmas.
Oh, one of my favorites.
Well, I already don't give a shit.
The Rock, wants to sing you 12 things that you can look forward to tonight.
What? Rock's going to sing here on SmackDown? Oh, boy.
And The Rock will go slow at first for you, Tess, just so you can understand. It goes like this. On a night, Tess faced the great one. This is what he'll see.
Wow.
12 sharpshooters stinging, 11 eyebrows raising, 10 spines a busting, 9 noggins knocking, 8 kicks a kicking, 7 punches punching, 6 suplex smashing, 5 seconds of the people chanting The Rock's name.
Rocky sucks. Die, Rocky, die. Die, Rocky, die.
4 rock bottoms, 3 people's elbows on your 2 buck teeth, and an ass kicking all over New Orleans.
That was pretty bad.
Rock sucks.
Oh, hey, Scott, I like this thing I just sent to you. I put in the Skype. It's called Uberfax. Every December 25th, a town in Peru celebrates Tacunacuy. Men, women, and children settle grudges with fistfights, then everyone goes drinking together, ready to start the new year with a clean slate.
That sounds like fun.
We might have to do that for the show.
Yeah, no, exactly.
I was going to say, I think everybody wants to take up Nick Anthony on that one. So, maybe we'll have to take up that one.
That could be a very interesting thing.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
What's wrong?
No, I'm just... I'm subbing tomorrow for a teacher.
Uh-huh.
And I'm a little upset because I didn't think about this, and I probably could have done it. But he's doing the 6-movie marathon leading up to some one certain movie that I'm not going to get to see on day one either. And I'm a little upset.
Oh.
What movie?
Huh?
What movie?
I am not going to say because I know you were talking how pissed you would be if we mentioned that movie.
Yeah, I'm going to fight you guys.
Yeah, no, well, that's what I'm saying. I'm a little teed off.
You mean that movie?
Yeah, I'm a little teed off because I don't have a ticket either yet.
So wait, he's taking the day off to go see the movie?
He's taking the day off to actually go watch a marathon of the original 6 and then... Yeah.
Motherfucker.
Yeah, so
wait,
I'm like,
wait,
damn
wait,
it.
Wait, 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 wait. He should lose his job. That's more fucking important than educating children. What kind of fucking human being is this?
He's
supposed
like 3 days
teacher?
Left to school before Christmas vacation.
Yeah, and he should
no
be
one's
at
getting
school.
Educated right now.
He okay.
No one gets educated in this country anyway. Common Core.
He's got vacation days he can take. It's one of those things where. It's one of those classes where I've taught that class multiple times. It's a government economics history class. It's okay. They're getting a test. I'm just basically there to proctor. So it's not a bad deal. And then Friday's a party anyway because it's like each class – Friday's the real joke. Friday, the school – literally every class period is like 35 minutes or 30 minutes. It's ridiculous. Like they get out of school at 12:30.
Oh.
Why?
it's a joke. It's stupid. It's basically them saying, hey, we can count an extra school day on the calendar.
Hey.
I like that.
Here we go.
But it's one of those things where usually it's every classroom has some sort of Christmas party or whatever, and they basically do nothing anyway. It's a waste of a day.
Look, it's not a Christmas party unless you're getting drunk.
Well, the fun part about that is if I can score a sub job for that day on Friday, I get a full day's pay, and I only have to work like 4 hours.
Well, I just found all the little video links on YouTube for the WWE's 2015 Slammies. Let's listen to them, and we'll give our picks. What do you guys think?
Oh, no.
That's
no, we are not even trying to remember that.
Let's not say you did.
That horribleness. Slammies are just horrible. Let's not relive those ever.
Oh, we have to relive
them. Indeed, let's not say we did.
Oh, hell, R-Truth took Mr. McMahon's limo for a spin. One day ago on the Raw Fallout show. Yeah.
Apparently, Daniel's drunk already.
Something. Yeah, I had a
hiccup. You know, I went and did myself some. I went and bought myself a fifth of Jose Cuervo. $10.
One round with Jose Cuervo.
Oh, no, it's one shot, and that's all I've had out the bottle. One shot.
Did you guys?
I'm pissed that I don't know about this one alcohol, this one tequila that I had at the movie marathon I went to when we did the slap shots. Mm-hmm. It was a really good fucking tequila, but they didn't know which one they gave us. That pissed me off because I really wanted to know what it was.
Okay, if
it was the smoothest fucking tequila I've ever had in my life.
Okay, so I have possible breaking news here.
Go ahead.
And again, take with a grain of salt because it's the Observer, so Meltzer lies like fuck. Breaking news, and everybody's going to give a standing ovation when they hear this news. Jeff Hardy out for the rest of the year and could need and is going to probably need another knee surgery that's going to take him out, not just the end of this year, out of 2016.
Jesus, what did he do to his knee to need all that?
Yeah, it sounds the way
this time.
So the way the report is, it just says the Wrestling Observer Newsletter reports Jeff Hardy will need another knee surgery and could be out of action until late 2016. Timetable for his return won't be revealed until after the surgery has been completed. Hardy has told the people that he will have to tone down his style and won't be able to compete as he was in the past. And right now, he's got maybe 4 months left on his TNA deal. So not even, like, barely even, just a little over 3 months. So, yeah.
Quick, grab a hold of me. Can't you just give me your arm?
Oh, wrong.
So, yeah, Jeff Hardy.
Poor bastard.
Yeah.
This is what it makes me feel like here.
Lock eyes from across the room.
I knew
down my drink while the rhythms boom.
Oh,
take
God.
Your hand and skip the
I know
names.
What this one is.
No need here for the silly games. Make our way.
Jeff Hardy's gone.
Crowd. The club is the sky and I'm on your cloud. Move in close as the lasers fly. Our bodies touch and the angels cry. Leave this place, go back to yours. Our lips first touch outside your doors. The whole night what we've got in store. Whisper in my ear that you want some more and I jizz in my pants. This really never happens, you can take my word. I won't apologize, that's just absurd. Mainly your fault for the way that you...
Wow.
My pants.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Well, we just heard that.
Yeah.
So yeah. And again, take it with a grain of salt. As if we confirm it and hear it from the horse's mouth, I'm actually trying to look up Jeff Hardy's info on Twitter right now to see if he confirmed it himself. And if he did, then...
Well, if you can't find Jeff Hardy, look for Jeff Harvey.
Yeah.
He might have information that Hardy doesn't.
It's my zombie love song.
Baby, but I see you around. It might seem kind of crazy, but I'm just new in town. And now I wonder what you think if I said, hey, look, I'd like to get your number and a link to your Facebook. Now, if I tell you what a nice guy's supposed to, would that compel you not to scream when I approach you? You'll have to promise me you'll take this news calmly. But honestly, I'm sort of a zombie. I knew you'd be surprised. You can bet that I may not be alive, but I should
zombie love
get
song.
Inside. What's with the shoddy? I ain't wishing you harm. You see, I try to hold you in, but I'm missing an arm. And brains are all I've eaten all week, it's true. But if my heart was still beating, it would be for you. So let me take you to Wendy's, you deserve it. Yeah, I'm a zombie, baby. Ain't nobody perfect.
What is this theme song? The Warm Bodies?
I don't know. It's called Zombie Love Song. By a YouTube channel called This Project Has Been Retired. Oh my goodness. Pikachu on Acid. Pikachu on Acid.
Great job on that last battle, Pikachu. Look at all this cash we won.
Help.
Oh my god.
Meanwhile...
What the?
So what's the deal with us? Are we like dating
it's
or
just,
what?
I'm
what
not
we...
looking for a relationship right
okay,
now.
This,
I mean, not
it,
with
it'd
a
be
woman.
Easier for us if we saw that one, too.
Yeah.
Man, we don't know what's going on, oh. Boob. This ain't helping.
Let's see. I'm trying to find a... Oh.
Oh, good lord. Okay, I just saw something else that I'm a little upset about.
What?
Star Trek Beyond will basically ignore Star Trek Into Darkness.
Oh, God.
Good, that was a horrible movie.
Yeah, I just don't like when they do stuff like that.
This might not be very good.
What? So then you must be hating the X-Men films right now.
Called yeah, Racist Mario. Ha-ha.
Now listen here, mister. I don't mean no trouble.
Go back into your own console.
But sir, I doesn't even have my own console. We're multi-platform now.
Knuckles?
It must be a Mario. He take racing too seriously.
He takes everything too seriously.
You motherfuckers invite non-Nintendo characters onto my track?
No worship for racing!
Oh, this is absolutely...
Holy shit! He's killing all the non-Nintendo racers!
What is he? Some kind of racist?
You're not Nintendo. You're pre-Tendo. You're all race traitors!
Whatever this is, can it not be played anymore?
Oh my god!
So Mario picked up one of them little circle cubes, threw it at the Chupa, and it broke all over him and stuck in him like glass. Funny as hell. Oh, he's got a banana now that looks evil. Anyway, yeah.
I'm glad we can watch this.
I wish we need to set this up on Google so you guys can see my screen when I do this, because this is pretty fucked up. Oh, he just shoved a banana down Donkey Kong's throat. Oh, poor donkey. Poor donkey. Poor donkey. Oh, God, now he got the bullet.
Poor donkey lips? What?
No, he
donkey
just,
lips.
He took a whole banana and shoved it down Donkey Kong's throat and killed him.
So who gets that donkey lips reference?
Camp on a wanna. Hold you in our hearts.
When we think about you, the sting
it makes me want to fart.
I always like the thing, it came apart. But, yeah. You know, if you got to do the it makes me want to fart part, how do you finish that?
It's I hope we never part. Now get it right or pay the price.
Yes!
I love that show. Salute your shorts. Greatest
run,
show on Nickelodeon.
We run, we jump, we swim and play, we row,
We row, we go on trips, but the
yes.
things that last forever,
are our dear friendships.
What's it called?
Salute Your Shorts.
One of the greatest shows ever existed. That and Pete and Pete were the best things that were ever like created.
See,
by,
I was never into Pete and Pete. I was never into that one.
That's because you're a horrible human being.
Probably. I watched Roundhouse. You remember Roundhouse?
No.
That was the one, it was kind of like... It was like a performing arts group did like fake spoof like after school specials.
Oh,
and it was really funny. They'd like break into song and do stupid things and stuff like that. And it would they would talk about like all the crazy little stupid things you'd probably deal with as a teenager.
I missed you can't
Except
say
for...
that on television.
There we go.
Camp on a wanna.
We hold you in our hearts.
It's I hope we never part. Now get it right or pay the price.
Now we will share a lifetime of the fondest memories by the lake of Onawana, sat in the pine trees.
Camp on, hold you in our hearts.
But when we think,
this is my heart.
Right.
One of the best shows Nickelodeon ever came up with. That wasn't animated.
I used to love
You Can't Say That on Television.
Hey, dude.
Yes! Hey, dude.
This is way before David's time, sorry. David was probably...
Yeah, I can get that.
You were probably like a newborn when these shows were coming out, because we were probably like...
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It's a little wild.
What?
Better watch out for those men, jackrabbits, and that killer cacti. Hey, dude.
wait.
You know what the weirdest thing is? If you remember Dodgeball, you mentioned it earlier.
Yeah. Christine Taylor, Ben Stiller's wife.
I know. And you just watch that and you go, oh shit, I remember her from Hey Dude.
Yep.
Let's see.
That was like the reason why I first watched Dodgeball. Like, I want to see what she's doing.
All right, which one is this, guys? Federal law prohibits authorized use of this videotape, such as spreading it with peanut butter and eating it, copying of this tape, or of test answers from the kid sitting next to you. Can be punished by being boiled in oil, stretched on the rack, shot, or being forced to watch this tape over and over until it wears out.
What the hell?
Miss Piggy sues the National Enquirer will not be seen at this time in order that we may bring you the following ugly rumor. Children of the Corn will not be seen at this time in order that we may bring you TV's corniest children. Jaws Eats Jacques Cousteau will not be shown at this time in order that we may bring you the following special program devoted to bathroom humor. Top Gun Gets Put on Latrine Cleaning Duty will not be seen at this time, so that we may bring you the following foul-smelling show. The video cassette you thought you were buying, the best of You Can't Do That on Television, cannot be sold at this time. Instead, we sold you a mess of garbage, the worst of You Can't Do That on Television. The great pain of this cassette, it proves they know nothing about money.
That was basically Nickelodeon getting a show from Canada that was basically like Saturday Night Live sketches.
No, actually, I think that's one of their Monty Python.
Yep.
Or Monty Python, yeah, that makes more sense. But the fun part about it was Alanis Morissette got her start on that show.
Yep.
My favorite was always Barf.
Come on, just like you said, water. Water fell on you.
Yeah.
I don't know! You get slimed.
Yep.
That's such an iconic moment that Nickelodeon still slimes people at their Kids' Choice Awards.
No refunds.
Okay?
The locker joke.
Most people may never even remember You Can't Do That on Television. Yet the sliming from that show has been ingrained in the history of Nickelodeon.
Mm-hmm.
So this show is actually one of the most important shows...
Nickelodeon history.
For Nickelodeon.
Oh, you just said something about this.
Star outfit? You don't look half bad. Christine, these cowboy boots are killing me. I didn't think becoming a pop star would be so hard on the feet.
Well, Alistair, all the girls will go for you.
Yeah.
I have to admit, you don't look bad at all.
Now I feel like I'm walking on air. Oh! Anyway, break it up, you two. Now listen, Alistair, do you have a song yet?
Well, yeah, Christine, it's about the oceans and rivers of love. But I have to make sure the songwriter doesn't mention the word water, or I'll get...
Ha ha. And it just happened.
drinking water dumped on his head from the captain.
You dunderhead! And now you've ruined your whole rock star outfit. Oh, my cowboy boots are all wet. They're shrinking. Oh.
Alistair, you're all wet.
Rock singers. Why not? Because they're a bad influence, Alanis. They dress funny, they make strange noises, and they act weird all the time, and I will not have any daughter of mine behaving like that.
Mom, that is a flimsy...
Valerie, I'm off for our monthly meeting of the Loyal Order of the Wildebeest.
Oh, God. Mr. Wizard's still a dick.
If I challenged you to balance this glass on top of this card like that, could you do it?
I don't think so.
Tough. However, I can do it. You got a good friend you'd like to play a trick on? This is how you can sort of play a trick on your friend.
Oh, God. You put the glass of water with the freaking card underneath it, and then you got to figure the glass out? Is that what that is?
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
You know, I'm going to see if this shit's on Amazon. I want to own this stuff.
Good day, yeah. In case you thought, like, I wasn't on this part.
Oh, I guarantee you, you'd be on. Okay, so good day. This is the Christmas part, and we're going to tell you
goodness.
What you get.
So apparently WWE just did a holiday edition of Bad Lip Reading, which is a knockoff, but it's called Bad Lip Sync, and it's wrestlers singing Christmas songs or whatever, or I don't know. I don't even know if I really want
to. Do I care?
I don't even know if I want to play this.
There's no DVDs for this.
Probably not. You probably have to watch them on the computer.
You can buy them from Nickelodeon for $6.99 for the season.
Oh, jeez.
On Amazon, but that's not the same, man.
You know what show I really liked way back when? Was Legends of the Hidden Temple.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
That one was great. You get a little bit of history, and you're
a lot of action, teams getting eliminated.
Freaking Temple Guards. Temple Guards
scared the fuck out of you.
Yeah. Dude, I was, you know what, twice when they've done live Nickelodeon live shows, I've actually been on stage twice. I wound up going at the theme park out here, Great America.
Okay.
They had a Double Dare show. Mm-hmm. At that time, I was still really, really young. So my dad spoke up and said something. I guess they were going to do a contest, and some kid had a hat on, and he was going to, like, peck the face off of somebody by accident with the hat. My dad yells, "Turn the hat around, okay?" And Mark Summers says, "Hey, sir, I'm coming back to you later." I'm like, oh, gosh, we're going to get up on stage? Holy crap. Well, my dad and mom had to have a milk chugging contest. My dad basically won, but because he spilled everywhere, I got to hit my dad in the face with a pie.
What would you do?
Yeah. That was
you're wrong. What would you do?
What would you do? / yeah, Double Dare kind of stuff. It was basically all the same crew.
It wasn't Double Dare, though. That was what? I know,
but they called it the Double Dare Super Show or whatever it was. But yeah, they played What Would You Do type games, yes.
Oh, God!
And then the second go-around...
I'm jealous so much right now.
The second go-around...
Hey, it's got DVDs.
We wound up... They had another one, and it was the Nick Arcade Guts Tour. I don't know if you remember those two shows. Nick Arcade was awesome. And Guts,
Nick Arcade was the shit, and of course I remember Guts.
Guts was amazing.
Who didn't want to take home part of the aggro crag?
Well, here's the fun part. So I got to go upstage, and I got to play a Double Dare-type game again. And my dad and I got up there, and my dad and a bunch of other dads were on the other side of the stage, and we each had these cool little slingshots made of funnels, and we had to shoot clothes from one side of the stage to the other. And the funniest part is, my dad actually watched the shows with me, so he knew the strategy. You didn't have to put the clothes on the right way, while the other dads actually tried to put the clothes on the right way.
You just had to wear all the clothing.
You just had to put them on somewhere. Well, we wound up breaking a record because in the 60 seconds, we got like 17 pieces of clothing, and like the nearest person to us had like 8.
Yeah.
And the fun part was the last thing I shot to him, he just grabbed and put it on his head. It was a bra. Yeah, so that was like the biggest laugh ever. And then later that day, my buddy who was with us got to play one of the the games where it looked like you're inside the video zone, and the snowball one, you're throwing the snowballs at the elves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he got to play that one. He sucked. He really didn't know what he was doing. I was like, damn it. That's not cool. So, but it was really funny to watch how they did it, like, because you're watching the screen and you see them on the screen in the video zone, and basically it's just people down at the other end of the stage rolling balls against the down up the stage at you. It was really weird.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Had he won this head-to-head matchup in that game, he would have gotten to play Slam Dunk, the Guts game.
Nice.
But he lost, so he didn't get to go.
Guts was great. Guts was so much fun to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, you know what's another one? Did you ever see Finders Keepers?
That was, yeah, I vaguely remember that one. That was like you got to go find random items in the house. It's kind of like Legends of the Hidden Temple.
But a lot less people jumping out of you trying to scare you to fucking death.
Yeah, that's for sure. And then Mike O'Malley got his start on Nickelodeon with Get the Picture, not even Guts.
No, but he really didn't get noticed until Guts.
Yeah, Get the Picture was actually really good. It was like classic concentration for kids.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, but let's be honest. We didn't watch Guts for Mike O'Malley.
It was a fun show. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I was going to say, did you have a crush on Moira Quirk?
Yes.
You did, really?
Yeah, that accent. Come on.
That's funny. I'm shocked I pulled out her whole name.
You can't tell me that she wasn't good looking and had a great accent.
Yeah.
Moira Quirk.
Here's a nice little ditty here.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah,
yeah, those are good old days, weren't they?
Uh-huh, back when Nickelodeon actually had decent shows. Oh gosh.
Classic.
Seems like a bad cover of Ironic.
Young man turned 21, went to the dispensary, got fired the next day.
What the
it's
freaking
fun
hell?
Getting high until you're late to work. Then your boss fires you and calls you a dork. Could it be the chronic?
Couldn't
be.
What the?
It's like being high and crashing into a car.
Okay.
It's always being
okay.
Too stoned.
Okay, this is just horrible. Why would you play
par.
This on air?
It's not.
Why would you ruin the show that we had by playing that on
anything
air?
Anything going on?
And you're still playing it. It's like you don't give a shit about the quality of the show.
I perform an all-clucking version of
really,
the song Ironic by Alanis Morissette. Please welcome the Jagged Little Chicks.
This is from Jimmy Fallon.
So I already hate it.
Yeah, I agree. Oh, God.
Oh, hell no.
What in the holy love of my fuck?
Oh, wait. This might be good. This could be
Ladies
good.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, combining the harmony of Barbershop Quartet with the music of Sting, please welcome the Ragtime Gal.
You don't have to put on that red, red light.
Roxanne.
You don't have to put on the red light.
Roxanne.
Those days are over. You don't have to sell your body to the night.
Roxanne,
you don't have to wear that dress tonight.
This ain't bad.
Walk the streets for money. You don't care if it's wrong or if it's right. Roxanne, put on the red light. Don't put on the red light. Don't put on the red light. Don't put on that red, red light.
Okay, Scott, I just found something that's right up your alley.
Roxanne, that wasn't too bad.
Scott, I found something that is right up your alley.
Oh, yes.
There is a Facebook channel for Antenna TV, which is it's a TV network that goes and shows all old TV shows. But the post that they put up there, It says, life was so much simpler when we could play a friendly game of Red Rover and just clothesline the fuck out of people we didn't like.
Yes, yes, and more, yes.
I added the fuck out of. So.
Yes.
That's funny. So or much. Dodgeball.
Let's see. That's Since so we funny. Had some bad That's pretty music, good. We need some really, really
oh, man.
Good music. Good music.
Lip, 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 lip.
Let's see.
Anyone get anything good for the holidays yet?
I just started, well, over the weekend, I did start doing my shopping, so at least I'm almost way there. I got to do more stuff over the weekend in person. No, I haven't gotten anything yet, but...
Here's an appropriate song for the...
How was your Hanukkah?
Hanukkah.
It was another 8 days.
Okay. Did you get a dreidel?
Some random Jewish kid gave me a menorah. On, like, the fifth night of Hanukkah. So he's like, oh, light it. I was like, okay. So apparently I lit a Hanukkah menorah for, like, 4 nights out of 8 because I was given 1. So what the hell?
Okay.
Nice. That's nice of him.
Here's a little political ditty from 1983.
Oh, gosh.
Very political. Can you name the song? It's Hot Topic right now. Nobody, huh? Nothing.
It sounds like Phil Collins.
It is Phil Collins. It's actually Genesis. You've never heard this song before.
Off the top of my head, now.
Oh my God.
I don't remember that.
1983, the Genesis album.
Okay, that song came out before I was born.
Seriously, I was a year old.
It's Genesis, though.
Oh, they're not that good.
Oh my! It's the same album that had Mama on it, which is one of the most...
Never heard of it.
You've never heard Mama?
Nope.
Oh my God.
I have a feeling we're going to hear it now.
Oh.
No, we're not, because show's over, everyone. Have a good night. Follow me at nexusdx.deviantart.com or scottndx at Instagram. Follow Daniel at whatever the hell Daniel has. Follow Boobs at whatever Boobs has. Good night, David!
Wow.
Seriously, we're hanging up now.
That's our outro music. It's a great song, by the way. Wow. So, there once was a man from Nantucket. Does anyone know that limerick, by the way?
Whose penis was shaped like a rocket or something like that?
No. There once was a man from Nantucket whose cock was so long he could suck it. He said with a grin while wiping cum from his chin, if my ear were a cunt, I would fuck it.
Okay, that's way worse than what I've heard.
That's what I was taught when I was a little tyke. That's the limerick.
That's
we
funny. Holy jeez.
Wow.
That was a fun show. Holy shit.
I can't believe you guys don't
know. I can't believe it went as long as it like, it kind of did. I just realized it's midnight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, this is going to, like, make your blood boil here, this last one I'm posting in here. David, you can't see it. I apologize. I will, here, I will, hopefully, I don't know if you're going to be able to see the tag on it on Facebook.
God, why am I downloading every fucking comic from Image Comics this week?
Hey, why, no, I can't tag you in this. That sucks.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so basically, David, it says, where are you, it says, where are you going with this? And it looks like Thor's confused. And it says, Disney owns Marvel. Marvel owns Thor. Thor is son of a king. Thor is now a woman. That means Thor is now a Disney princess.
I would find that absolutely hilarious if they made him a Disney princess.
I posted something the other day about Princess Leia being a Disney princess, and they were talking. It was like some random joke. Let me see if I can find it. Hang on. Let me see. I posted it on my page. Oh, yeah. Hey, 3 tickets to Alvin and the Chipmunks to the Road Ship, please, said no moviegoer ever on December
9th. Oh, I saw that.
and legitimately, one of my friends posted pictures of a car actually ran into an intersection, ran into a wall, with this painted on it. And I want them to laugh first.
Before
I tell David.
Yeah, I saw it already.
All right.
I already saw it.
So, what's the difference between a G-spot and a golf ball?
There's a bad joke in there about being in the hole.
Who the fuck thought that was a good idea?
A guy will actually search for a golf ball.
Uh-huh.
What does a sign on an out-of-business brothel say? Beat it, we're closed.
Huh?
Beat it, we're closed.
Uh-huh.
Why was the guitar why was the good the guitar teacher arrested?
He something about a minor.
For fingering a minor.
That's funny.
What's the difference between a tire and 365 used condoms?
I don't know.
One's a good year, the other's a great year. Why does Santa Claus have such a big sack?
Don't know.
He only comes once a year.
God damn it.
What's the difference between a
hooker? You leave his medical condition alone!
What happens? What's the difference between a hooker and a drug dealer?
I don't know.
A hooker can wash her crack and resell it. What do mafia and pussies have in common?
I don't know.
One slip of the tongue and you're in deep shit.
Hey, Scott, I think you'll like this one. I saw this the other day, and it's the scenario is you're in the White House. Any good ideas on how to defeat ISIS? Joe Biden raises his hand. The person says, besides assembling the Avengers? Joe Biden lowers his hand.
What did the banana say to the vibrator?
What did the banana say to the vibrator, Adam? Oh, God, I don't know.
Why are you shaking? She's going to eat me.
Yeah.
What does Dr. Why does Dr. Pepper come in a bottle? Because his wife died. What's the best part about sex with a 28-year-olds?
Oh, God.
Fuck you, Daniel.
This is...
Which one?
What do you think?
Kalisto, heads up.
Oh, shit.
That's good. I mean, I love condoms. That's what I don't talk.
Oh, hell no.
You see my Stormtrooper snowflakes?
Oh.
No.
That's funny.
Yeah, chat. I did.
Oh, Lord.
Somebody already posted the Wheaties box. We said that right on the air the other day. Yeah,
I posted that in the...
Yeah.
God damn it, I can't find that picture now. It was like Luke and Solo were making fun of Princess Leia about being a Disney princess and something about, like, oh, she's a Disney princess for Alderaan reasons.
What does one saggy boob say to the other saggy boob?
I don't know.
If we don't get some support, people will think we're nuts.
Yeah.
What's the best part about gardening? Getting down and dirty with your hose.
Oh my God.
How is a girlfriend like a laxative? They both irritate the shit out of you. What do you call the useless piece of skin on a dick? The man.
Oh, jeez.
Why do vegetarians give good head? Because they're used to eating nuts.
All right.
What's the difference between your wife and your job? After 5 years, your job will still suck.
Jesus.
Oh, my God.
All right. On that note, I'm going to...
Oh, and the last one. Why did God give men penises?
Oh, gosh.
So they'd have a way... So they'd have at least one way to shut a woman up.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah.
Oh, for...
That comes from Thought Catalog and the 50 dirty jokes that are never appropriate, but always funny.
That's funny. All right, well, I'm going to go watch the end of TakeOver.
So I'm just going to finally watch it.
Yeah, oh. Well, I watched the first match and then fell asleep. But took a cat nap.
You know what a 6.9 is?
Oh, gosh.
Another good thing screwed up by a period.
Oh my God.
That was really good.
That one's actually pretty good. On that note,
good night.
Good night, guys. Have a good
night. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
All right.
Good night, everyone.
Peace.